वेदर में
सर स्क्रीन विजिबल सर।
या वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस क्लास। सो आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द सब्जेक्ट ग्राफ थ्योरी। यस्टरडे आल्सो आई टोल्ड यू। ओके नाउ द फर्स्ट यूनिट ग्राफ्स। इन दिस यूनिट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज ग्राफ एंड व्हाट आर द टर्मिनोलॉजीज यूज्ड इन ग्राफ्स थ्योरी। ओके फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट इज ग्राफ। A graph is nothing but a pair of sets v comma x, where v is the vertex set and x is the edge set. Okay, so very important, v is, I mean, vertex set always non-empty. So v contains only the set of all vertices. Similarly, x contains only the set of all edges. Okay, another definition, very important one, adjacent vertices. There is an edge between the vertices U and V in a graph G, then U and V are called as adjacent vertices. Next, if the two edges X and Y have a common vertex E in a graph G, then X and Y are called as adjacent edges. Okay, so these two topics are we discussed yesterday. Another very important notation, a graph G containing P vertices and Q edges, we denote like P comma Q graph. Understand? Now let us see from the example. Yes, here you know that A, B, C, D, E, these are called as vertices. This line, nothing but edge, you know that. So in this graph, there are five vertices and five edges. Okay, and you know what is mean by adjacent vertices. For example, if you take A and B, there is an edge between the vertex A and the vertex B, so that A and B are adjacent vertices. Similarly, A and C are adjacent vertices, C and D are adjacent vertices, B and D are adjacent vertices, D and E are adjacent vertices. Thus, all are having individually vertices, sorry, edges. Now, how to denote this graph? P equal to V comma X. I told you, P comma Q graph means that P means number of vertices, Q means number of edges. So, what is P? What is P? I mean, number of, how many number of vertices in this graph?
Five, sir.
Five. So, P equal to five. What is Q? That is number of, how many number of edges?
Five,
five. So we denote this graph five comma five graph. Are you clear? So this is a way of denoting the graphs for any graph. Okay. Next, one of the example of graph we call as Petersen graph. Actually, 10, 15 graph is called as Petersen graph. Means that this graph containing 10 vertices, 15 edges. The shape will be like this. Okay, you may count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 vertices. Similarly, edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So, 15 edges. So, this graph is called as Petersen graph. Next, very important. Now we are going to discuss some basic types of graphs. First, loop or self loop. A loop or self loop is an edge that connects a vertex to itself. Means that, see the graph, it is visible, right? See this graph, understand ma? So, this is a vertex B here, and edge that starts from the vertex and finishes the same vertex. So, vertex one edge, but the edge starts from V and end. So that this is a self loop or okay. Next, multi graph. if two vertices are joined by more than one edge, then the graph is called as multi-graph. So whenever the graph containing multiple edges or parallel edges, example here, see that A and B are vertices. Here, this is an edge, this is another edge. So there are two edges, sometimes maybe three edges. So these are we called as multiple edges or parallel edges. The corresponding graph is called as multi-graph. Understand? Do you understand, Mark? What is loop? What is multi-graph? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Next, very, very important concept, graph theory, complete graph. What is complete graph? A graph in which there is an edge between every pair of vertices called a complete graph. So, if it takes any pair of vertices, there must be an edge between them. That corresponding graph is called as complete graph. The complete graph containing suppose n vertices, we denote kn. Kn notation represents complete graph of n vertices. Kn example is this. This is a graph. As I told you in the beginning, vertex set always non-empty, but edge set may be empty. So, you see this graph. This is a graph containing only one vertex. This is also a graph. So, it is, we denote K1. This is another graph. There are two vertices, one edge. What is the definition of complete graph? There is an edge between every pair of vertices. Here, no pair of vertices, only one vertex. So, there is no edge. So, it is, we denote K1. But here, there are two vertices. There is an edge. So, that it is a complete graph of two vertices. We denote K2. Next, another graph. There are three vertices. If you take any pair of vertices, there is an edge. Take two vertices, an edge. If you take these two, an edge. If you take these two, an edge. So, if you take any pair of vertices, there is an edge. So that it is a complete graph here containing three vertices, so that we denote K3. Similarly, another graph. There are four vertices. If you take any pair of vertices, there is an edge. Take any pair, wherever, however. So, it's the complete graph of four vertices. We denote K4. Similarly, this is K5 because it contains five vertices. If you take any pair of vertices, there is an edge. Could you understand? K1, K2, K3, K4, K5, etc. K6, K7, and so on.
Yes, sir.
Am I clear? What is complete graph? Next. Null graph. What is null graph? A graph whose edge set is empty, called a null graph, or totally disconnected graph. Where it is, I have given, you can able to find out, which one null graph? Here.
K1, sir.
Very good. K1 is a null graph, or totally disconnected graph, because edge, there is no edge in this graph. Understand? Next, labeled graph. A graph is said to be labeled if its n vertices are distinguished from one another by names such as V1 to N. Yeah, very simple. You put label for vertices, we call the corresponding graph is labeled graph. Okay. What about these graphs are, whether these are labeled or not?
K3, K4, K5 labels.
No, that is notation for complete graph. Here,
no, sir,
no
sir.
Graph not having labeled. Am I right? So, these are not, yes, labeled. Understand? Yeah. What about this graph?
Labeled, sir.
Labeled graph. Understand? Next, another important concept, bipartite graph. A graph P equal to V comma X is said to be bipartite or bigraph. The vertex set E can be partitioned into two disjoint subsets, V1 and V2, such that every edge of G joins the vertex of V1 to a vertex of V2. See, what we do to take the vertex set, if possible, we have to partition it into two disjoint sets. Then, to take any edge that will that connects the vertex set V1 and V2. If it happens, the corresponding graph is called as bipartite graph. Understand for an example, I will come later on. And another one, complete bipartite graph. If a graph P contains every edge joining the vertices of V1 to the vertices of V2, then this is called a complete bipartite graph. Notation, V1 contains suppose M vertices, V2 contains suppose N vertices, then we denote K, M, comma, N. Okay. Particularly K1, comma, is called a star. Yeah, now let us see an example. Yeah. See, this is a graph. This is a graph. You know that. See the first graph. Here, we may able to separate into two cases. Understand? See that in this graph, we may split the vertex set into these two. You may understand? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We may consider this is V1, this is V2. Actually, it is a one graph, but the vertex set we are divided into two, V1 and V2. Why I am taking like that? If you see that, now see the edges. You see, if you take this edge, connect vertex set V1 and vertex set V2. Similarly, if you take this edge, connect V1 and V2. This edge, V1 and V2. This edge, connect V1 and V2. This edge, V1 and V2. Could you understand? So, this is the definition of bipartite graph. Am I right? Right or not? Are you clear? If you don't understand, you tell me, Ma. Generally, I can able to know.
One second.
Yeah. No problem. See, we divided the vertex set. Actually, in this graph contains how many number of vertices?
Six.
Very good. Now, we divided into two by these three vertices as a one vertex set V1. These three vertices as another vertex set V2. Okay. Now, look out. Isn't the edges? See the edges. That edge connect the vertex set V1, the another vertex set V2. Similarly, if you take any edge, all the edges connect the vertex set V1 and V2. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So that this graph is called a bipartite graph. Similarly, see this graph. Here, we may divide likewise. This is V1, this is V2. V1, V2. Similar thing happened here. You may understand? See the edges or take any edge that will connect the vertex in V1 and another vertex in V2. Am I right? So that it is also a bipartite graph. The third example. Take that. This is V1. This is V2. You take any edge that will connect the vertex V1 and V2. So these three graphs are bipartite graphs. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Next, another definition, complete bipartite graph. What is the difference between bipartite graph and complete bipartite graph? You can understand these from these three examples. See, what is the definition of complete bipartite graph? The same definition, bipartite with additional condition. One is that all the edges must be joined. I mean, V1 and V2. If you see the first graph, design. So see the first graph. Listen. Edge is there. If you take these two vertices, edge is there. Because we consider this is V1, this is V2. So, the V1 contains 3 vertices, V2 contains 3 vertices. What we needed, all the vertices 3, here all the vertices 3, both must be connected by an edge. If you take these two vertex, here is no edge. Am I clear? Similarly, if you take these two vertices, there is no edge. Similarly, if you take these two vertices, no edge. So, but the definition of complete bipartite graph is all the pair of vertices V1 and V2 must be connected by an edge. Yeah. So it is bipartite but not complete bipartite graph. What about this second one?
It is a complete bipartite.
Yeah, very good. Because
each vertices are connected to
all V2 the vertices of V1 and V2 are connected by an edge. So this is a complete bipartite graph. The third example also complete bipartite graph. Okay. Yeah, for a complete bipartite graph, we may denote. I told already this is V1. So having 3 vertices, this is V2 having 3 vertices, so we denote K3, 3. Second is this third graph, V1 contains 2 vertices, V3 contains 3 vertices, so we denote K2, 3. Now you may understand what is complete graph, what is complete bipartite graph. Any
yes,
doubt
sir.
You may ask me from anybody, any others. Till now, what are the things we discussed? What is graph? What is adjacent vertices? What is adjacent vertices, edges? Then what is null graph or totally different graph? What is labeled graph? Then what is complete graph? Then what is bipartite graph? Then what is complete bipartite graph? These things are different. Any doubt, you may ask me. This is